Good morning, students. I am your SSC teacher, Mrs. Manju Sharma, and today we will start our second chapter in history, Socialism in Europe and the Russian Revolution. Children, as you read in previous chapter about the French Revolution, and we know that the French Revolution opened up the possibility of creating a dramatic change in the way in which society was structured. As we know, that before the 18th century, society was broadly divided into states and ordered, and it was the aristocracy and church which controlled economic and social power. Suddenly, after the revolution, it seemed that the possible change this in many parts of the world, including Europe and Asia. New ideas about individual rights and who controlled social power began to be discussed. In India, Raja Ram Mohan Rai and other revolutionaries of the significance of the revenge revolutions and many other debates the ideas of post-revolutionary Europe. Today, in this chapter, we will learn about the Russian Revolution. Not everyone in Europe, however, wanted a complete transformation of society. The views of the different people were different. Socially, and there are three types of people: radicals, conservatives and liberals. What did these terms really mean in the context of the time? What separated these stands of politicals and which linked them together? We will learn all of these in this chapter. First of all, we will learn about liberals, radicals and conservatives. One of the group which looked to change society were the liberals. Liberals wanted a nation which tolerated all religion. We should remember that at this time, European states usually discriminated in the favor of one religion and other. Liberals also opposed the uncontrolled power of dynastic rulers. They wanted to safeguard the rights of individuals against government. And radicals wanted a nation in which government was based on the majority of country's population. Many supported women's suffragette movement. Conservatives were opposed to radicals and liberals after the French Revolution. However, even conservatives had opened their minds to need for changes. It means they want change, but gradually they want change in their society. Now, we will learn about the industrial and society and social change which took place after Russian Revolution. These political trends were sign of new time. It was a time of profound social and economic changes. It was a time when new cities came up and new industrialized regions developed, railways expanded, and the Industrial Revolution occurred. The coming of socialism to Europe. Perhaps one of the most far-reaching vision of how society should be structured was socialism. Socialists were against private property and saw it as the root of social ills of the time. They believed that property should be divided in proper manner and in all the people. Socialists had different vision of the future. Some believed in idea of the cooperatives. Robert Owen, a leading English manufacturer, sought to build a cooperative community called New Harmony in Indiana, USA. Karl Marx and Friedrich Engels added other ideas to this body of argument. Marx argued that industrial society was capitalist. Capitalist owned the capital invested in factories, and the profit of capitalist was produced by worker. So the profit should be divided into the worker. Now we will know about the support of socialism. Who support the socialism in Russia? Workers in England and Germany began forming association to fight for better living and working condition. They set up funds to help members in times of distress and demanded a reduction of working hours and the right to vote. In Germany, these associations worked closely with the Social Democratic Party, SPD, and helped to win parliamentary seats by 1905. Now, we will learn how the Russian Revolution occurred in Russia. In one of the least industrialized of European states, this situation was reversed. Socialists took over the government in Russia. Through the October Revolution of 1917, the fall of monarchy in February 1917, and the events of October are normally called the Russian Revolution. Russian Empire in 1914. What was the situation before 1914? In 1914, Tsar Nicholas II ruled Russia and its empire. Beside the territory around Moscow, the Russian Empire included current-day Finland, Latvia, Lithuania, Estonia, parts of Poland, Ukraine, and Belarus. Now we will study the economy and society of Russia. At the beginning of the 20th century, the vast majority of Russian people were agriculturists. About 85% of the Russian Empire's population earned their living from agriculture. Industry was found in pockets. Prominent industrial areas were St. Petersburg and Moscow. In 1890s, when Russia railway network was extended and foreign investment in industry increased, coal production doubled and iron and steel output quadrupled. Most industry was the private property of the industrialist. Workers were a divided social groups, linked with the village from which they come. Despite division, workers did unite to strike, work for stop work. When they disagreed with employers about dismissal or work conditions, these strikes took place frequently in the textile industries during the 1896 and 1897 and in the metal industry during 1912. Russian peasants were different from other European peasants. In other way, they pooled their land together periodically and their commune divided it according to the needs of individuals. So, students, this was the system of industry and agriculture in Russia. Now, we will study about socialism in Russia. All political parties were illegal in Russia before 1914. The Russian Social Democratic Worker Party was founded in 1898 by socialists who respected Marx's ideas. Some Russian socialists felt that the Russian peasants' custom of dividing land periodically made them natural socialists. They formed the Socialist Revolutionary Party in 1900. This party struggles for peasants' rights and demanded that land belonging to nobles be transferred to peasant social democrats, disagreed with social revolutionaries about peasant. The party was divided over the strategy of organization. Vladimir Lenin, who led the Bolshevik party, thought that in a repressive society like Tsarist Russia, the party should be disciplined and should control the number and quality of its member. Other Menshevik thought that the party should be open to all, as in Germany. A turbulent time, the 1905 revolution. Russia was an autocracy. Unlike other European rulers, even at the beginning of the 20th century, Tsar was not subject to parliament. Liberals in Russia campaigned to end this state of affairs together with the social democrats and social revolutionaries. Prices of essential goods rose too quickly that real wages declined by 20%. So the gap between wages and between goods was very far. Over the next few days, over 11,000 workers in St. Petersburg went on a strike, demanding a reduction in the working day to 8 hours, an increase in wages, and improvement in working condition. When the procession of workers led by the father Gapan reached the Winter Palace, it was attacked by the police and the Cossacks. Over 100 workers were killed and about 300 wounded. The incident known as Bloody Sunday and started a series of events that become known as the 905 Revolution. Now, the First World War and the Russian Empire. In 1914, war broke out between two European alliances, Germany, Austria, and Turkey. the Central Powers and the France, Britain and Russia, later Italy and Romania. Each country had a global empire, and the war was fought outside Europe as well as in Europe. This was the First World War. The war also had a severe impact on industry. Russia's own industries were few in number, and the country was cut off from other supplies of industrial goods by German control of the Baltic Sea. Now we will know about the February Revolution in Petrograd. In the winter of 1917, conditions in the capital Petrograd were grim. The layout of the city seemed to emphasize the divisions among the people. On 22 February, a lockout took place at a factory on the right bank. The next day, workers, about 50 factories, called a strike in sympathy. In many factories, women led the way to strikes. This came to be called the International Women's Day. On 24th and 25th, the government called out the cavalry and police to keep an eye on them. On Sunday, 25 February, the government suspended the Duma. By that evening, soldiers and striking workers had gathered to form a Soviet or council in the same building as the Duma met. This was the Petrograd Soviet. The very next day, a delegation went to see the Tsar. Military commanders advised him to abdicate. Duma leaders formed a provincial government to run the country. Petrograd had led the February Revolution that brought down the monarchy in February 1917. What happened after February? Army officials, landowners and industrials were influential in the provisional government, but the liberals as well as socialists among them worked towards an elected government. Restrictions on public meetings and associations were removed. Soviet, like the Petrograd Soviet, were set up everywhere, though no common system of elections was followed. In April 1917, the Bolshevik leader Vladimir Lenin returned to Russia from his exile. He and the Bolshevik had opposed the war since 1914. Now he felt it was time for Soviet to take over power. He declared that the war be brought to be close, land be transferred to the peasants, and bank be nationalized. These three demands were Lenin's. April is known as April Thesis. Now, the revolution of October 1917. As the conflict between the provisional government and the Bolshevik grew, Lenin feared the provisional government would set up a dictatorship. On 16 October 1917, Lenin persuaded the Petrograd Soviet and the Bolshevik party to agree to a socialist seizure of power. A military revolutionary committee was appointed by the Soviet under Lenin, Trotsky, and to organize the seizure. The date of event was kept a secret. The uprising began on 24 October, sensing trouble. Prime Minister Kerensky had left the city to summon troops at dawn. Military men loyal to the government seized the building to two Bolshevik newspapers. Now we will look what were the changes after October. The Bolshevik were totally opposed to private property. Most industries and banks were nationalized in November 1917. This meant that the government took over ownership and management. Land was declared social property and peasants were allowed to seize the land of the nobility. The Civil War. When the Bolshevik ordered land distribution, the Russian army began to break up. Soldiers, mostly peasants, wished to go home for the redistribution and deserted. Supporters of private property among whites took harsh steps with peasants who had seized land. Partly to remedy this, most non-Russian nationalists were given political autonomy in the Soviet Union, USSR, the state the Bolsheviks created from the Russian Empire in December 1922. But since this was combined with unpopular policies that the Bolsheviks forced the local government to follow, like the harsh discouragement of nomadism, attempt to win over different nationalists were only partly successful. Making a socialist society. During the Civil War, the Bolsheviks kept industries and banks nationalized. A process of centralized planning was introduced. Officials assessed how the economy could work and set targets for a five-year period. Stalin and collectivization. The period of the early planned economy was linked to the distress of the collectivization of agriculture. By 1927 to 1928, the towns in Soviet Russia were facing an acute problem of grain supplies. Stalin, who headed the party after the death of Lenin, introduced firm emergency measures. He believed that rich peasants and traders in the countryside were holding stocks in the hope of higher prices. Speculation had to be stopped and supplies confiscated. In spite of collectivization, production did not increase immediately. In fact, the bad harvest of 1930 to 1933 led to one of most devastating famines in Soviet history, when over 4 million died. The global influence of Russian Revolution. Existing socialist parties in Europe did not wholly approve of the way of the Bolsheviks took power and kept it. However, the possibility of a workers' state fired people's imagination across the world. In many countries, communist parties were formed, like the Communist Party of Great Britain. Yet by the 1950s, it was acknowledged within the country that the style of government in USSR was not in keeping with the ideals of Russian Revolution. By the end of the 20th century, the international reputation of the USSR as a socialist country had declined, though it was recognized that socialist ideas will enjoy respect among the people. But in each country, the ideas of socialism were rethought in a variety of different ways. So, the students, we have learned about Russian Revolution and its impact on the world. Goodbye. We will see in the next video.